The four kinds of transportation: planes, trains, boats, and automobiles. But one preeminent entrepreneur wants to create a new fifth transport method. Hey people, Trace here for D News with the lowdown on a new technology announcement: Hyperloop. Elon Musk thought of it. He is a billionaire creator of PayPal, CEO of Tesla Motors, and SpaceX. So when he talks, the tech world stops tweeting for about a half second to listen. The specifics of how Hyperloop would work are still under wraps. Further details are coming next month. But extrapolating from what Musk said in June, it will be able to go from San Francisco to Los Angeles in 30 minutes and New York to LA in 45 minutes. The plan, we think, is to create a Jetson-like bank-style vacuum tube transport system. The transport can't crash and it floats like an air hockey puck. It's pretty fantastical. The project will cost $6 billion, relatively cheap for an ultra-fast transport system, and will ideally be solar-powered. Though, there is not an announced plan yet. Experts have already weighed in, and people are pretty excited. As long as we're waiting, I gathered a couple of other things that we should make some plans for. Firstly, a space elevator. I mean, rockets are cool and all, they make a lot of noise, and they create some fantastic pictures. But there is a better way to get into space, if we can figure it out. A space elevator is simply a 22,000-mile cable with a 900-ton elevator crawling up and down it. Real simple. Some plans call for a platform floating in the Pacific around the equator, and the other platform is in space. With a price of about $10,000 per pound for a rocket, a space elevator would reduce that to about $100 to $400 per pound, theoretically. There is one tiny problem. We just are not smart enough to make it. The plan was to use carbon nanotubes, but we can only make them a few inches long at a time at the moment, and they're looking like they may not even handle the tensions involved. So we're stuck on the ground, for now. By the way, water travel could also be revolutionized. This is a technology called supercavitation. Scientific American calls it warp speed for underwater ships. Cavitation happens around the edges of propellers. It has to do with the physical behavior of fluids. Swiss mathematician Daniel Bernoulli discovered that fluid velocity is directly related to pressure and density. So when you carve through the water in the right way, like a propeller, for example, you force it to change state to conserve energy. If we did this rapidly and constantly across the whole surface, we could cause supercavitation, which would theoretically form a bubble of vaporized water around an entire vessel. That bubble could reduce the friction and increase potential underwater speeds by 60 to 70%. That is a lot. Unfortunately, like the space elevator and the theoretical Hyperloop, we have not quite figured out this one either. But the future of transportation looks bright and fast and bubbly. Tell us which of these technologies you think we should be putting all the money into, or perhaps another one of your favorites. And make sure you come find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus so you do not miss the special behind-the-scenes stuff. That's right. Thanks a lot for watching D News, everybody. I'm Trace. See you later.